हेलो, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन. माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर अरविंद कुमार, एंड टुडे आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग द लिवर डिजीजेस. दिस इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ योर प्रेडिक्टिव सीरीज विच वी आर रनिंग ऑन द यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ डेम्स डेली. सो टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ लिवर डिजीज़, एंड आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग इट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ क्लिनिकल साइन एज वेल एज द स्पेसिफिक डिजीजेस. So hopefully audio and video, everything is clear to all of you. There is no issues. All right, so this predictive series will be helpful for not only the final year MBBS students as well as for the PG entrance going students as well as for the medicine PG residents also. So I will be covering more of a clinical aspect of these liver diseases. So let's start with the clinical signs of the liver disease, important clinical signs of the liver disease. So this is the first sign. So I will be asking some of the questions and then moving on to that concept of that sign. So question is, a 30-year-old male presented with these findings associated with fatigue and low appetite. All of the following can be the causes of this clinical sign. So this finding is given to you and you have to identify ki, what is not the cause of this clinical sign. So options are with you: hemolytic anemia, acute viral hepatitis, obstructive jaundice and keratoanemia. These are the options given to you, and here is the clinical sign which is asked to you. So this is the clinical sign here. So what is not the cause of this clinical sign? Yes, hemolytic anemia, acute viral hepatitis, obstructive jaundice or keratoanemia. What will not lead to this sign? Yes, I am getting the answer as option number D. All right, any other answers? Option number D, yes. So, what we are finding in this sign, we are finding the yellow sclera. So, this is a yellow sclera. This is known as icterus. So, the clinical sign here is icterus. And for icterus to get produced, the serum bilirubin should be minimum to minimum. The value of serum bilirubin should be more than 2.5 milligram per deciliter. It should be 2.5 milligram per deciliter. So what will not cause this sign? It will be keratoanemia. Yes, great. So it will not cause, because keratoanemia, it is due to excessive consumption of the vegetables which are high in carotene content. So it spare the icterus, sorry, it spares the sclera, this color. So it will not be seen in the sclera. So that is a unique property, and bilirubin has a high affinity for the tissue of sclera. So therefore it is deposited there. So what will be the other concept of this jaundice? The patient is presenting with the jaundice. So I will be giving you the concept. Like if a patient of jaundice is coming to you, jaundice is icterus. Patient of jaundice is coming to you. So what you have to do to identify the etiology of the jaundice, either you can go for the test or you can go for the clinical feature. So this means the serum bilirubin is high. High serum bilirubin. It is the meaning. So then look for the urine of the patient. If urine is clear, clear means normal, or urine is dark. If it is clear, that means it is a elevation of predominantly elevation of a unconjugated bilirubin. This is unconjugated bilirubin, which is responsible for the jaundice, and important causes here will be hemolytic anemia. Hemolytic anemias. While other causes can be a congenital disorders of unconjugated high bilirubin like Gilbert syndrome, or it can be a Crigler-Najjar syndrome type 1 or type 2, like that. These can be the examples. So just one urinary finding will give you a clue of differential diagnosis. Now, when the urine is dark means ki bilirubin is there in the urine, so it is a case of a increased conjugated bilirubin. So what you have to do? Then you have to look for the liver enzymes. So liver enzymes will be either normal, or liver enzymes, inflammatory enzymes, SGPT elevated, or obstructive enzymes like ALP or gamma GT elevated, like that. So in this, this will clear-cut make your diagnosis based on the liver enzymes. Based on the liver enzymes. So if it is normal, then it will be a rotor syndrome, or it could be a Dubin-Johnson syndrome. Dubin-Johnson syndrome. While if it is SGPT is elevated, then a single diagnosis of hepatitis or hepatocellular jaundice you can make. Just make hepatitis as the diagnosis. While if ALP and gamma GT they are elevated, that means it is a case of a obstructive jaundice. Obstructive jaundice. So with this simple flow chart, you can identify the etiologies. Etiologies of the jaundice that you are dealing with. You are dealing with. Then the clinical history will give you a clue about the diagnosis of these disorders. Now, some point about the liver enzymes. This is a clinical question sometimes is given to you, and I have seen many students struggling with the interpretation of the liver function test or the liver enzymes. So let's start with some discussion on the liver enzymes here. So liver enzymes interpretation. So first I will be taking the inflammatory liver enzymes. So the first is inflammatory markers. Inflammatory markers, liver enzymes. So the inflammatory marker, the most specific liver inflammatory marker is the SGPT, which you also know in the lab as ALT. ALT. This is most specific because the location is in the liver only, while the other is SGOT. But it has got other locations as well. It can be cardiac muscles. Cardiac source, you have seen that in a case of myocardial infarction, SGOT is elevated. You have also seen like in Duchenne muscle dystrophy, Baker's muscle dystrophy, SGOT is elevated. So it could be a skeletal muscle also. Skeletal muscle. Or it can be also elevated in a hemolytic anemia from RBCs. Any renal pathology can cause the SGOT elevation. So this is quite a non-specific marker of inflammation. So what is the normal value? The normal value for these marker is both of these is 10 to 40 international units per liter. That is a normal value. Now, when the liver inflammation is there, they are released into the blood. But very importantly, you should know that levels of SGOT and SGPT does not correlate with the severity of liver disease. Does not correlate with severity. Does not correlate with severity. Second important point, the level of more than इंटरनेशनल यूनिट्स पर लीटर. इफ दैट इज गिवन इट विल मेक द डायग्नोसिस वेरी स्पेसिफिक और डिफरेंशियल डायग्नोसिस विल बी नैरो डाउन. इफ दिस इज गिवन इन योर एमसीक्यूज और इन योर एग्जाम्स, सो देर आर ओनली थ्री कॉजेज फॉर दैट कंडीशन. सो इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ एक्यूट वायरल हेपेटाइटिस, इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द टॉक्सिन और ड्रग इंड्यूस्ड, एंड थर्ड कॉज इज इट इज इश्मिक, इश्मिक और कंजेस्टिव. ओनली एंड ओनली थ्री कॉजेज लीड्स टू सच अ एलिवेशन. वाइल द एलिवेशन ऑफ द रेशियो एस जी ओ टी अपॉन एस जी पी टी रेशियो, इफ इट इज मोर देन वन, दैट कैन बी सीन इन एनी सिरोसिस ड्यू टू एनी कॉज. रिमेंबर व्हेन द रेशियो इज मोर देन इक्वल टू वन, एनी सिरोसिस, बिकॉज फाइब्रोटिक सेल्स डज नॉट री अपटेक द एस जी ओ टी. एस जी ओ टी देर इज अ नॉर्मल री अपटेक, देर इज अ नॉर्मल री अपटेक ऑफ एस जी ओ टी. सो इफ फाइब्रोसिस अकर द रेशियो विल बी मोर देन वन, एंड दिस रेशियो इज नोन एज अ डी राइटिस रेशियो. दिस रेशियो इज डी राइटिस रेशियो. वाइल अदर रेशियो दैट इज एस जी ओ टी अपॉन एस जी पी टी, इफ इट बिकम मोर देन टू, इफ इट बिकम मोर देन टू, देन इट इज हाईली स्पेसिफिक फॉर एल्कोहलिक लिवर डिजीज, एल्कोहलिक लिवर डिजीज. सो दीज आर द इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ दीज इन्फ्लेमेटरी मार्कर्स ऑफ द लिवर. वाइल द लिवर एंजाइम्स इट कैन बी द ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव मार्कर्स ऑल्सो, एंड इफ वी विल लुक एट द ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव मार्कर्स, ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव मार्कर्स. सो ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव मार्कर्स दे आर ए एल पी. सो ए एल पी इज द ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव मार्कर. आई विल मेक द ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव मार्कर हेयर ए एल पी रोल नॉर्मल वैल्यू. ओके, व्हाट इफ द रेशियो इज मोर देन टू एंड देर इज नो हिस्ट्री ऑफ एल्कोहल. दैट मीन्स कि मोस्ट लाइकली द पेशेंट इज हाइडिंग द हिस्ट्री ऑफ एल्कोहल, बिकॉज टेलिंग द हिस्ट्री ऑफ एल्कोहल इज नॉट वेरी गुड ऑन द पेशेंट पार्ट. सो दैट कुड बी वन रीजन. एंड अदर रीजन कुड बी, इट कुड बी अ नॉन लिवर डिजीज, नो अदर कंडीशंस विच कैन लीड टू द एलिवेशन ऑफ दिस रेशियो, लाइक द डिजीज वेर देर इज अ हीमोलिसिस, वेरी हाई डिग्री ऑफ हीमोलिसिस इज गोइंग ऑन, तो एस जी ओ टी लेवल विल बी वेरी हाई. लाइक वी हैव सेड कि हीमोलिसिस कैन कॉज अ हाई एस जी ओ टी लेवल्स. सो दैट कुड बी वन रीजन. सो इट कुड बी द नॉन लिवर कंडीशंस विच लीड्स टू द एलिवेशन ऑफ दिस रेशियो. नाउ द ए एल पी, ए एल पी इज अ नॉन स्पेसिफिक मार्कर ऑफ द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन, बिकॉज इट कैन बी रेज फ्रॉम द बोन्स ऑल्सो, फ्रॉम द इंटेस्टीन ऑल्सो. लाइक इन्फ्लेमेटरी बाउल डिजीज इट कैन बी एलिवेटेड फ्रॉम द इंटेस्टीन. सो इट इज नॉन स्पेसिफिक. नॉर्मल वैल्यू इज 50 to 150 इंटरनेशनल यूनिट्स पर लीटर, 50 to 150. वाइल गामा जी टी, गामा जी टी रिमेंबर इज अ वेरी सेंसिटिव मार्कर ऑफ द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. सेंसिटिव, इट इज इंक्रीज वेरी फास्ट. द नॉर्मल वैल्यूज 10 to 60, 10 to 60. वाइल 5' न्यूक्लियोटाइडेज, न्यूक्लियोटाइडेज इट इज वेरी स्पेसिफिक. इट ऑल्सो इंडिकेट अ लिवर मेटास्टेसिस, लिवर मेट्स इट इज एलिवेटेड देयर, एंड द नॉर्मल वैल्यू इज 0 to 10 इंटरनेशनल यूनिट्स पर लीटर. So, how to identify that the ALP, if it is elevated, is from the liver source, not the bone source or not the intestinal source. So, you look for the other markers of the obstruction. Other markers of the obstruction are elevated, then yes, it is most likely from the liver. So, this is a interpretation of these obstructive markers for liver. Now, come to the next question. So next question is coming to, so after the description of the jaundice, the liver function test, especially the enzymes. Now the next question, let me see who can give me the correct answer first. This skin lesion is caused by the skin lesion is this skin lesion, and I will give you a description. The central part is the arteriole, and these are the capillaries. So if you compress a central part, it will become pale, and when you lift the finger up, the blood flow in a outward direction. Yes. What is your answer? This is a case of a spider nevi. Yes, spider angioma or spider nevi. Great. So it is caused by liver failure. Yes, it is liver failure, thyrotoxicosis. Yes, pregnancy. Yes, as well as it is caused by oral contraceptive use also. Oral contraceptive use. So answer is all the above. And can anyone tell me how many number of spider nevi will make the diagnosis of liver failure? Means then it will be more likely a liver failure. How many number of spider nevi should be present to call that it is the liver failure which is responsible for this spider angioma or spider nevi? So this is a case of a spider angioma. So yes, for liver failure 2 or 3, no, it is more than equal to 5. More than equal to 5, then it become relatively more specific for a case of liver failure. Yes. Yes, it is in the distribution of the superior vena cava distribution. And also, if it is located at atypical location, like it is present on the trunk or on the legs, then also it will suggest that it is due to the liver failure. Now, come to the next one. The next question. A 50-year-old male with a history of alcohol-induced cirrhosis present with these findings. What is the mechanism of this finding? Look at the diagram. So 50-year-old male with this finding present to you, and there is a cirrhosis. There is a cirrhosis here. So what is the mechanism of this finding? Whether it is a high prolactin level, whether it is a low testosterone level, or it is a high estrogen, or it is a direct alcohol effect. So here first I will make a clinical diagnosis that you are dealing with a case of a gynecomastia. So this is gynecomastia. So gynecomastia is mainly because of the high estrogen level. And why high estrogen level? Because of decreased metabolism in liver, in diseased or cirrhotic liver. Liver is failed. Yes, so it is a case of a gynecomastia, and it is the high estrogen which is responsible for this, not the prolactin level or a high. This is a misconception that high prolactin level cause the gynecomastia. No, remember, gynecomastia is due to high estrogen level, otherwise endocrine question also. Now the next question, which of the following history and sign, which of the following history and sign will be assessed in this patient with the finding of hand like this? Whether you will take a history of alcohol, you will see icterus, or you will ask for the diabetes mellitus in this patient. So this is the clinical sign that you are getting. This is a clinical sign you are getting here. All right. So this clinical sign, if you can see, this is a diputerine contracture. Yes, this is diputerine contracture. Yes. So how this diputerine contracture occurs? So I am getting the answer as C and D options. So maximum options I am getting as the D option. So diputerine contracture is because of alcohol. Yes, true, alcohol causes it. It is caused by diabetes mellitus. Yes, it can be caused by a diabetes mellitus. Then we are left with the option icterus. Yes, if it is a alcoholic liver disease, then icterus can also be there. Gynecomastia can also be caused by spiral electron therapy. Yes, gynecomastia can also be caused by, that is a drug effect, spiral electron, true, spiral electron. And also dupuytren contracture can also be caused by trauma. It is caused by trauma. And the reason, the mechanism for this dupuytren contracture is fibroblast activation by TGF-beta. TGF-beta is increased and that lead to the elevation of fibroblast. But why it is increased? It is increased because of microvascular injury by these pathological process. Microvascular injuries like diabetes mellitus, like alcohol, they cause microvascular injury. Microvascular injury means there will be elevation of TGF-beta. This is the culprit molecule which leads to fibroblast proliferation and the fibrosis of this part of the hand. So it is seen, so you will look for all these in the history, as well as trauma, as well as the smoking. Smoking is also implicated in the pathogenesis. Now coming to the next one. So the next is all the investigations will be indicated. All the investigations will be indicated in the patient having this clinical sign. So let's see what is the clinical sign here. All right, so this is the clinical sign here, which of the investigation will be indicated in our patient. Whether you will go for a plasma glucose level, liver function test, MRI brain, or the TSH, So here you can see that there is the Palmar erythema present, So the diagnosis here is Palmar erythema. Palmar erythema. Let me see the answers. B option, B option. So maximum are giving the answer as a B option. Now the Palmar erythema can be due to, if we look at the causes. Now look at the causes. It can be because of the liver failure, no doubt. Liver failure. So we will be going for a liver function test, true. While Palmar erythema can also be because of the thyrotoxicosis. Yes, thyrotoxicosis can also be leading cause. Thyrotoxicosis. Liver failure, thyrotoxicosis. And also Palmar erythema can be due to rheumatoid arthritis. Yes, this is also implicated. Angiogenesis vascular factors are increased in rheumatoid arthritis. So they lead to the Palmar erythema as well. Palmar erythema can also be caused by, it can be due to diabetes mellitus. Again, neoangiosis. Neoangiosis means ki new vascular formation can be there in the diabetes mellitus. Yes, diabetes. It can also be the effect of drugs like Emedron. Emedron is also implicated for Palmar erythema. And brain tumors. Brain tumor, very good. Pituitary adenomas. So brain tumors can also lead to the Palmar erythema again because of the angiogenesis vascular factors are increased. So all of these can lead to the Palmar erythema. And of course pregnancy, physiological condition, pregnancy will lead to Palmar erythema. So should we have a plasma glucose level done? Yes. Should we go for an MRI? Yes. Direct etiology. We will be getting a direct etiology from these. TSH, yes. Thyrotoxicosis. So answer to this question is all the above. So it will be a multiple correct type of question. So it is all the above will be the answer here. Yes. Now, let's come to more clinical questions in the clinical sign. So you observe a dilated veins on the patient abdominal wall. The direction of the blood flow is assessed. Name the likely cause of pattern A and pattern B. Look carefully in this pattern. So the pattern A is the blood is going away from the umbilicus towards the SVC and the blood is going towards the IVC. So it is going away. So what is the A pattern due to? when we look at the direction of the blood flow, we compress the veins and then release the distal end or a proximal end. So that will tell us ki where is the blood flow going into. So this is the A option, and the B option is the blood is going superiorly towards the SVC, superiorly towards the SVC. So blood flow is upward from inferior to the superior direction. So what will be the etiology for the B? All right. So caput medusae, yes, this is caput medusae. So A option is yes. What will be the A option? Correct. All of you are right. A option is due to portal hypertension. Great. This is due to portal hypertension. The blood will go towards the systemic veins like a superior vena cava from the portal vein obstruction site. So upward and downward towards the IVC. Yes. And B. B is when there is an IVC obstruction, collaterals are made and they will bring the blood towards the superior vena cava. So this is inferior vena cava obstruction. Yes. Great. So A is portal hypertension and B is inferior vena cava obstruction. Great. Now come to let's come to, so these were the clinical signs that we have seen. Now we come to the specific liver diseases. So I have picked very important and very common liver diseases. So let me see who can identify these liver conditions, the patient coming to you, presenting to you with these signs and symptoms. So let's start with the first one. Look at the first one. So read the question very, very carefully. A 50-year-old patient presented with the lesions on the limb. There are lesions on the limbs. He also has an episode of GI bleeding. Vasculitis is suspected. So there were some lesions on the limb, and the physician is suspecting that there could be some vasculitis. So on investigation, ANCA is negative. ANCA is negative. On the examination of the on further examination in view of deranged LFT, HBS antigen was positive. HBS antigen was positive. Yes, you are making it right. So likely cause of this vasculitis will be a granulomatosis with polyangiitis, previously known as vaginosis, microscopic polyangiitis, eosinophilic granulomatosis with polyangiitis, which is Chuck Strauss, or polyarteritis nodosa. So will your answer change on the basis of the picture? Let me see. Let me see. Will your answer change after looking at the clinical picture of this patient, 50 year old? So these are the lesions which are present on the limbs. So you can see these are the lesions. These are like a net. Yes, this is a net-like lesion. So net-like lesion, what is this net-like lesions known as on the limbs and on the hand? So this is because of the vasculitis. Great. This is a polyarteritis nodosa. Yes, this is a polyarteritis nodosa. It is lividoreticularis. Remember, these net-like lesions on the limbs, these are nothing but lividoreticularis. Reticularis. Yes. And because the HBS antigen, remember, this is a very important lesion associated with the case of hepatitis B, polyarteritis nodosa. 30% of polyarteritis nodosa have HBS antigen positive. HBS antigen positive. Yes. This is a horizontal integration like rheumatology question and the liver question. Yes. Now coming to the, yes, 30% with HBV. Yes. So the liver biopsy of this patient was done. Liver biopsy of this patient was done as follows. And these are the important liver findings which are seen. And you look at the arrow. Look at the arrow. What is the sign name or what is the pattern of this liver biopsy? What is this pattern of the liver biopsy known as? And look at the arrow. Look at the hepatocyte. This is a one hepatocyte. Look carefully. One hepatocyte. न्यूक्लियस इज एट द पेरिफ्री, न्यूक्लियस इज एट द पेरिफ्री, यस व्हाट इज दिस, ग्रेट, इट इज अ केस ऑफ अ ग्राउंड ग्लास अपियरेंस, यस डॉक्टर अंशु, INICT 21 हैव गिवन द आंसर फर्स्ट, सो दिस इज अ केस ऑफ अ ग्राउंड ग्लास पैटर्न, यू कैन सी दिस इज अ ग्राउंड ग्लास पैटर्न एंड व्हाट इज दिस ग्राउंड ग्लास पैटर्न, इट इज नथिंग बट द HBS एंटीजन पार्टिकल्स, दिस इज अ यस दिस इज द टिपिकल, दिस इज ऑल्सो अ ग्राउंड ग्लास अपियरेंस, दीज सेल्स यू कैन सी दीज सेल्स, these are ground glass appearance, so ground glass appearance is present and this is HBS antigen particles, these are the HBS antigen which deposited in the cytoplasm, which are deposited in the cytoplasm of the cells, liver biopsy, great. Now coming to the next one, so next one, next clinical case. A patient has these bullous lesion and photosensitivity with deranged liver function test. Liver biopsy finding were done, likely cause in that case. So patient has bullous skin lesions, photosensitivity is there, and LFTs are deranged. So we will think what could be the pattern here. So this is the bullous lesions, you can see bullous lesions, bulla formation, photosensitivity is there and this is the liver biopsy pattern because of the deranged LFT, the biopsy of the patient was done and here is the biopsy pattern. So what is your answer? What is this liver disease due to? Whether it is a alcoholic liver disease, whether it is hepatitis B, whether it is hepatitis C, or whether it is hemochromatosis. So again, I am summarizing the findings. So it is a case of a bullous lesion, photosensitivity. Bullous lesion, photosensitivity, liver is deranged, liver function deranged. So who has given me the correct answer first? Dr. Anshu has given me the correct answer first. Dr. Anshu, yes. Great. So this is what you are able to see in this diagram whenever you are seeing white things. So I will give you just a gross hint. I will not give you any details of the pathology. So whenever you are seeing these white things here, this is all fat. So this is all fat. And mesh-like structure, this is a blue structure, the cells are not there. So this is fibrosis. Fibrosis. And what is this fat? Fatty liver. So in a first go, we will think of that it is a case of an alcoholic liver disease or a non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. Yes, it can be a presentation of these conditions, but we have to make a clinical diagnosis based on the information given to us. And what was the information given to us in the previous thing? It is the bullous lesion is given and a photosensitivity. So it is some sort of a cutaneous lesion. So anyone, what is this cutaneous lesion will be there? That cutaneous lesion is a case of a porphyria cutanea tarda. Porphyria cutanea tarda. So whenever there is a skin lesion, a bullous lesion, photosensitivity is given to you with a liver problem. So think of porphyria cutanea tarda. This hint I have given to you. So tell me, porphyria cutanea tarda is the extra hepatic manifestation associated with which chronic liver disease? Porphyria cutanea tarda. So whenever this patient comes, we do a test, a serology, and that serology we do for hepatitis C. So answer here is it is a case of a hepatitis C that is associated with, yes, correct, that is associated with porphyria cutanea tarda. Photosensitivity should give you a hint on the diagnosis. Now, but why fatty liver is coming in a hepatitis C? Why fatty liver? Remember, hepatitis C leads to causes insulin resistance. It causes insulin resistance, and insulin resistance causes fatty liver. So you will get this type of finding in cases of the hepatitis C condition. Yes. Now come to the next one. So next is these are the just the fact-based questions. These are all extra hepatic. Extrahepatic manifestations of hepatitis C. Extrahepatic manifestations of hepatitis C. So, autoimmune thyroiditis, yes, that can be a possibility. Very importantly, beta cell non-Hodgkin's lymphoma can be the extrahepatic manifestation of hepatitis C. Important MCQ. Lichen planus, yes, very common. Any patient of the lichen planus always go for a hepatitis C serology, mandatory. Mixed cryoglobulinemia, yes, it is possible. And indeed, this is the most common renal manifestation of hepatitis C. Mixed cryoglobulinemia or just cryoglobulinemia. Though the pattern of the biopsy in the kidney, will be a membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis. Monoclonal gammopathies can be there in hepatitis C. So you can see hepatitis C can be responsible for the immune reactions. Porphyria cutanea tarda, this was our case today. Porphyria cutanea tarda, yes. Thyroid cancers, yes, there is a possibility. And a renal cell carcinoma, they are associated with hepatitis C. So this could be a new potential question. Whenever cancer is a risk or cancer is an association for these infections, so that become a potential question. So these are all extra hepatic manifestations of hepatitis C. Now the next one. All right, come to the next question. Clinical case. A 60-year-old female presented with 1 year history of fatigue. She complains of pruritus, especially in the evening. Examination findings are shown in the figure. Investigation shows elevated conjugated bilirubin with raised ALP. Ultrasound abdomen is normal. What should be your next step? So raised ALP is seen along with the elevated bilirubin. So it is a obstructive jaundice. What will you do? You will go for a AMA test, ANA test, angiography, or biopsy of the skin lesion. So let me see whether your answer will change after seeing the diagram or not. So this is the diagram. So what is this diagram suggestive of? This diagram is suggestive of these are the xanthelismas, cholesterol deposit. Yes, these are xanthelismas. And these are on the tendons, the cholesterol deposit on the tendons. You can see. So these are xanthomas. Yes, these are the xanthomas. Very good. So it will be hypercholesterolemia which is happening here. So what is my likely diagnosis in this case? My likely diagnosis will be anti-mitochondrial antibody. AMA will be my answer. Now when I go for the biopsy, so in the biopsy is the very important test here. So in the biopsy you can see this is intrahepatic bile duct. This is a bile duct, and around the bile duct, if you are able to see many number of cells with so many nuclei, dark blue color is there. Infiltration of a number of cells will make that blue colored area. So and rest of the liver parenchyma, you can see pink color, that is okay. So this is all proliferation of the cells around the bile duct. So this is a non-suppurative इंट्राहिपेटिक बाइल डक्ट इन्फ्लेमेशन. सो नॉन सपोरेटिव इंट्राहिपेटिक बाइल डक्ट इन्फ्लेमेशन इज देयर. सो दैट मेक्स अ डायग्नोसिस ऑफ प्राइमरी बिलियरी कोलिंजाइटिस. नाउ आई विल गिव यू द डायग्नोस्टिक क्राइटेरिया फॉर प्राइमरी बिलियरी कोलिंजाइटिस. एंड दिस डायग्नोस्टिक क्राइटेरिया इज इफ एनी ऑफ टू, रिमेंबर, इफ एनी ऑफ टू फीचर्स आर प्रेजेंट दैट विल मेक अ डायग्नोसिस ऑफ प्राइमरी बिलियरी कोलिंजाइटिस. एंड समटाइम बायोप्सी मे नॉट बी नीडेड. सो दिस इज द ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव मार्कर्स एलिवेशन विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड नाउ. सो ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव मार्कर्स एलिवेटेड लाइक ए एल पी गामा जी टी दे विल बी एलिवेटेड. नंबर टू, इफ देयर इज ए एम ए एंटी माइटोकॉन्ड्रियल एंटीबॉडी एलिवेटेड, ग्रेट, इट विल बी इंक्रीज्ड. प्रोराइटिस इज स्पेसिफिक फॉर पीबीसी. आउट ऑफ द लिवर डिजीज इट इज रिलेटिवली स्पेसिफिक, यू कैन से. वाइल बायोप्सी पॉजिटिव फॉर दीज चेंजेस. सो ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव जो मार्कर्स ऑफ द लिवर डिजीज ए एल पी गामा जी टी 5' न्यूक्लियोटाइडेज, एलिवेशन ऑफ द एंटीबॉडी एंड बायोप्सी पॉजिटिव. सो एनी ऑफ दीज टू इज अ डायग्नोस्टिक क्राइटेरिया फॉर प्राइमरी बिलियरी सिरोसिस. यस. नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट वन. सो नेक्स्ट वन इज आई हैव टेकन इट स्लाइटली फ्रॉम द रिसेंटली कंक्लूडेड योर एग्जाम. सो अ 20-year-old मेल प्रेजेंटेड विद बोथ हाइपोकाइनेटिक एंड हाइपरकाइनेटिक मूवमेंट्स. हाइपोकाइनेटिक मीन्स रिजिडिटी, हाइपरकाइनेटिक मीन्स द ट्रेमर्स. एंड द जनरल फिजिकल एग्जामिनेशन शोज दीज फाइंडिंग. द लाइकली कॉजेज प्राइमरी बिलियरी कोलेंजाइटिस, प्राइमरी स्क्लेरोजिंग कोलेंजाइटिस, ऑटोइम्यून कोलिंजाइटिस और विल्सन डिजीज. सो व्हाट आर ऑल दीज डिजीजेस? रिमेंबर, ऑल दीज आर क्रॉनिक कॉलीस्टेसिस कंडीशंस एंड ऑल ऑफ देम कैन कॉज के एफ रिंग्स, कैन बी पॉजिटिव. रिमेंबर, ऑल ऑफ दीज कैन कॉज अ के एफ रिंग पॉजिटिविटी. यस. बट द टिपिकल फीचर ऑफ दिस इज अ के एफ रिंग, द ब्राउनिश रिंग विच यू कैन सी एट द पेरीफ्री ऑफ द कॉर्निया. ऑल ऑफ दीज कंडीशन प्राइमरी बिलियरी कोलेंजाइटिस, प्राइमरी स्क्लेरोजिंग कोलेंजाइटिस, ऑटोम्यून कोलेंजाइटिस और अ विल्सन डिजीज, ऑल ऑफ देम कैन कॉज के एफ रिंग्स, करेक्ट. बट दिस क्लासिकल प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ हाइपोकाइनेटिक एंड हाइपरकाइनेटिक मीन्स बेसल गैंग्लिया इज इन्वॉल्व. सो इट विल बी ओनली अ विल्सन डिजीज, इट विल बी ओनली अ विल्सन डिजीज विच विल बी प्रेजेंट हेयर. यस, हाइपोकाइनेटिक एंड हाइपरकाइनेटिक मूवमेंट्स. यस, इट इज अ केस ऑफ अ विल्सन. सो दीज वर द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्लिनिकल केसेज ऑफ द विल्सन डिजीज. सो हेयर इज द बायोप्सी ऑफ द लिवर वॉज डन इन आवर पेशेंट ऑफ द विल्सन डिजीज एंड दिस वॉज अ रोडानिन स्टेन विच वॉज डन. सो दिस वॉज द लिवर बायोप्सी डन इन आवर पेशेंट. सो इफ यू सी ऑरेंज कलर्ड, रिमेंबर दीज आर ऑल ऑरेंज पार्टिकल्स, ऑरेंज कलर्ड. सो दिस इज हाईली सजेस्टिव ऑफ कॉपर स्टेनिंग. सो ऑरेंज कलर, दिस इज नथिंग बट अ कॉपर. सो दैट वे यू कैन मेक डायग्नोसिस ऑफ द विल्सन डिजीज कॉपर. All right. So now come to the next clinical case. So the next clinical case is 65-year-old female. Chronic liver disease is there. Chronic liver disease and patient has pain in these joint areas. So look at these joint area. These are the second and third. This is a second MCP joint and this is a third MCP joint is there. So with some abnormal skin pigmentation is there. abnormal skin pigmentation. So what will you do next in the clinical case? So second and third MCP joint pain is there, abnormal skin pigmentation, chronic liver disease. So think broadly, whether it is a SLE case, whether it is a rheumatoid arthritis case, or what exactly is this, or gout case. So AMA test, RA factor with anti-CCP, or iron studies will be done, or a skin biopsy will be done in our patient. So this will be a case of do not get biased. Do not get biased ki this is a topic of liver disease, so you will mark the hemochromatosis. So that bias can be there. So remember, whenever there is a second or third MCP joints are affected characteristically, this is a case of a pseudo gout. Remember, these joints are very, very specific for the pseudo gout presentation. So it will be a case of a hemochromatosis. Yes, iron studies will be done. Abnormal skin pigmentation is there. That also give a clue, as well as the liver disease involvement will give you a clue here. Yes, this is hemochromatosis. Correct. And which stain is this where the iron particles are appearing as blue color? Iron particles. This is a iron particle. So yes, this is a case of, yes, Prussian blue stain. Correct. Blue colored iron particles in the liver biopsy. All right, so this was our session for today. It was for 45 minutes. So we have finished well in time. And this was a quick revision of your exams, including the clinical signs as well as the specific diseases of the liver. And if you have any doubts, do leave a comment under this video. I will be happy to solve that doubt. And all the best for your upcoming exam. Best of luck. Stay safe, stay healthy. Take care. Bye.